Hey folks, it's Ray, DCRamRecord.com here, and today GoPro has announced a new GoPro Hero 8 feature, which allows you to use your GoPro as a webcam with normal apps like Zoom or Teams or really anything. Anything that accepts a webcam can now accept a GoPro. And that's a pretty big deal because up until now, you couldn't actually somehow do that. Like, never before. You could go ahead and use something like the media mod on the Hero 8, but this cost 80 bucks. Then you still need to go ahead and have an HDMI connection on the other side, but you couldn't just use a normal USB cable to a GoPro and get video out of it. But now with today's beta, you can. I did say beta because the way GoPro is announcing this is that it's considered an open beta. Anybody can download the firmware onto the GoPro, update it, and use it with virtually any app you want. And I've used it with a number of apps thus far, but GoPro has a huge list of them. They include Zoom, Microsoft Teams, Google Meet, Discord, Twitch Studio, OBS, WebEx, Skype, Facebook Rooms, Facebook Messenger, Slack via Google Chrome, really anything that accepts a webcam. So in this video, I'm gonna walk you through step-by-step how to do that. There's a link in the description there as well where you can download the firmware update that you need. It's not something that's gonna come to your GoPro camera by default. So you do have to go and download the update manually. Down the road, once GoPro releases this publicly, then it'll just magically show up in your camera and you're good to go. You can go ahead and use the chapters function in YouTube, skip along on the timeline of the video right there to get to the point that you want. Okay, so with that, we're gonna go ahead and get started. You're gonna need four things. You're gonna need a GoPro Hero 8 Black. There's only one Hero 8, but a Hero 8 Black will not work with the Max, will not work with the Hero 7 or Hero 6 or 5 or 4 or 3, 2, just the 8. You will need a USB-C cable that plugs into it. So just your normal GoPro charging cable will work. And you will need a micro SD card in here. So we'll have to take that out in a second, and a micro SD card reader with that. So I guess that's five things then. And then the fifth thing, but now it was the fourth thing, you will go ahead and need a Mac. Yes, a Mac. Your PC won't work, a Mac, just for now, just during the beta, at least the first part of the beta. GoPro has not yet released the PC version, so today it's Mac only. GoPro says that's coming really, really darn soon. So what you want to do is go to the GoPro site that I've linked in the description there. This is their beta site, and you'll scroll on down, and you'll see the Get Started option. You'll tap that, and then from there, what you do is you want to download the firmware. Right there, it says GoPro beta or webcam beta firmware. You're going to download that to your computer. So we'll save that right there. Then once that's saved, go ahead and click on Show in Finder, and you'll see it right there. So when you double click this, it'll go ahead and open up a new folder, create a folder for you. This one right there, and you'll see update inside of it. Now, what you want to do is take your GoPro, open the door up, have fun with that, and then take the battery out. And then take the micro SD card out. And then you need a reader. I've got this like $6 one. This video, by the way, will be a raised tour of random $6 accessories that I have. So $6 micro SD card reader, plugging it into my Mac. Oh, hey, and a quick note, if you're finding this video useful or interesting or something like that, just simply whack that like button at the bottom there. It really helps out this video and the channel quite a bit. And now what you do is go ahead and take this update folder, the whole folder as is, click edit, copy, and then go to your micro SD card so that you see the DSIM folder at the top and so on, and then click paste right to that folder right there. It's really as simple as that. Again, the update folder has to be shown at the top level just like that, DSIM, the same level there. Once you've got that done, you can go ahead and pull this out, take out your micro SD card, go ahead and attempt to stick it back in here. There we go. Put the battery back in. There we go. Close this up. And what you'll see happen here, if I get this lined up there on the camera, that's actually the old beta firmware, but in a second, it'll start the process for updating the firmware. There we go, that's the icon, and update complete. Simple as that. Now, with that done, we need to go back to our computer and download the GoPro webcam software. So again, on the same page we left off on, go a little bit further down, download GoPro web desktop utility, webcam desktop utility. We'll save that into the folder there. And then you can just click on at the bottom here to open it up. And now we'll go ahead and install it. So I'll just walk you through these steps. You're basically just going to click next a bunch of times. Pretty straightforward. Continue installation. And we're almost done. Done. Now it will require you to restart it. So you got to do that in order to go ahead and get things to work. Now in my case, I already updated this camera here. But this one was the one we just did right now. So for fun, I'll put this out of the way. And this camera is on, so you do have to ensure that's powered on. And then you can put it in the, oh, that's right, the GoPro door doesn't have a hole in the side because it's the Hero 8. So we're gonna go back to my other camera, which does. In case you haven't seen my video on this amazing little accessory right here, you've got the ability to plug the cable straight into the door, which makes it ideal for this exact thing. And now when you do that, you're going to see a USB icon there. So we go up to the top now and click this and hit show preview. And this will show the preview of the webcam itself. So you see it right there. And then up here, it says webcam. So it's hard to see. Let's see if I can tilt it just right. Just like this, we'll tap this to make sure it sees it. There we go, webcam right there. And on the back, what you've got is the webcam red up in the top there. You've got 100% battery because it's plugged in this case. It'll stay at that percentage of battery. The SD card, it will not record to the GoPro itself. And then you can go ahead and see a preview there. Now in this setup and the beta at this point, it is recording or showing or transmitting at 1080p, 30 frames per second in the wide setting. There is no method to change that except to go to 720p. So if you go up to the GoPro, just get this GoPro page out of the background here and get this out of the background. I will make myself my preview a bit bigger so you can see what's going on. There we go. But if you go up the top there in the GoPro webcam utility, you will see pause webcam. So this would pause it, of course. And you see preferences, which would really just be renamed preference because there's only one preference in there. You can choose 1080p or 720p. Obviously, I'm not going to do 720p. So leave it there. And that's it. Now, there is one cool little trick here. In the bottom right, barely visible, is a button that says flip. And that'll go ahead and change it, the picture, and flip it. And that's useful if you have text behind you. So a conference call I did earlier on today, I was down in my office side of this, and I have some posters on the wall. And so by using that, I went to flip it, and that went ahead and made the text behind me the correct orientation for the people in the camera. But you do you and figure out how you want things to look. At that point, you're done. This is the webcam that's accessible to the Mac for any app out there. So to show that, I'm gonna run through a couple different apps. So in my applications window here, I'm gonna go down and find Zoom. We'll start there. And I choose new meeting. And then what you'll see is it may choose the GoPro by default, but it may not. So if it's chosen your built-in web camera, it would be something like this. Let me just pull it up here. There we go. You can see much more zoomed in. The quality isn't as sharp. And if I go and choose the GoPro webcam from the little arrow next to stop video, now I've got the full webcam there. Now, one thing to keep in mind is it's not going to use any of the audio from the GoPro. You can't choose that. If I go into the settings for this, for example, over here on audio, there is no option to even choose up here at the top the GoPro. So it's just simply the built-in system, and that's it. But if you look at this image, A, it looks super, super crispy and sharp. B, it's nice and wide. So I've got the image there, the photo, the poster. I've got my whole desk behind me. It just looks really, really nice. In my previous conference call before this, people were like, oh, that's a pretty nice overall view. It's very sharp looking. So that's good. Now, if we needed to flip the image like I showed before, you can do that, but it won't go ahead and use that flipped image until you stop and start the camera for that particular app. So you will need some sort of audio with it. In my case, I just use AirPods because they work pretty well. Also, again, on the Rage Tour of Random Things, like a $5 case accessory with the carabiner makes so much sense to hook on a backpack and stuff like that. And then from here, you would just use your audio like normal. Nothing special about that. Okay, so for the next app, I will crack open Skype here. Double click on this and go up into the settings, the dot, 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 settings again, down to audio and video. And then for the camera, just ensure it's selected for GoPro webcam as opposed to FaceTime webcam there. It's as simple as that. You'll again notice down the microphone, there is no GoPro option. You will need to have some other headphones or microphone or just your built-in. Now beyond Skype, I also use it for Microsoft Teams on a call just before this. No problems at all. You can see a quick screenshot B-roll thing of that right there. It worked great. And I actually kept the preview window open on the side, kind of wider for most of the call, just because it was easier to see what was going on behind me, given it was such a wide view. That is one thing to keep in mind, that it is only the wide lens. So if you have other stuff in the scene, you might want to be aware of that compared to the kind of the more cropped in version on your camera. GoPro did say that they're working on one, adding more resolution. So the fact that it tops out at 1080p today, down the road, I asked about 4K, that said it's definitely on their goal list. And the same goes for what they call their digital lenses. In other words, a linear view, that's the non-fisheye view, as well as perhaps other digital lenses, which includes the super view, which is a super wide, extra fisheye kind of view. And where those may be more useful is more on the content creator side than on the conferencing side. So for that, we'd probably use something like OBS. So cracking open OBS here, this is super common to use across many, many different platforms. And you can see here is my OBS setup. I'm just gonna add a new camera in there. So I go down to the bottom, hit plus, I click on video capture device. I'm gonna call it GoPro Hero 8, click okay. And then I'm gonna go into the device up here and just simply choose GoPro webcam. And it's really as easy as that. And then I hit okay. And now I resize this up if I want to match, there we go. and I'm done. And that's literally all there is to do for getting my GoPro into this. Now, of course, you will have to have probably a longer cable if you want to put it further away. In this case, I've got like maybe a meter and a half cable or so, because keep in mind, the original GoPro cable is quite short, but it's just a USB-C cable. I'll link to a few of the ones that I use around the studio that are longer length without any problems down below as well. And the same is true for Facebook as well, whether it be a Facebook page as like an entity or going to a Facebook Rooms or Facebook Messenger, all of that can leverage as webcam. So here in my Facebook page, I just scroll up, I hit the live button right there, and then I'll go down and it'll give me the option to choose the camera once this whole control room kind of fills up there. The same is true for YouTube Studio as well, if you want to do it on YouTube live broadcasting. So you see up the top here, it says waiting for live video. Now, depending on how you've set up your Facebook settings, it may be waiting for you to go down and choose use camera. Otherwise, it says use stream key, which is what I usually use when I'm broadcasting to Facebook, but I choose use camera. And if I scroll back up again on this one here, you will see it's using the camera from my laptop. So I had to go back down again and then down into setup at the very, very bottom there. And you'll see this camera right here for a GoPro webcam. And now I can go back up the top and you'll see that wide view there. And again, this is sort of it's just a much, much cleaner, much, much crispier image. And it's definitely something that just looks a heck of a lot better. Now, just before I forget, one thing to show you on the back of this, when I'm in the webcam mode, there's nothing you can do. Like you can't swipe, you can't press the mode button does nothing here at all. The record button does nothing. Like, it's in complete toddler mode. You cannot do anything to this at all, except just look at the pretty picture on the Mac. That's it. And then again, it's got the blinking red light up there and it says webcam on the front of it, but that's it. Okay, so one last item to mention here is that you can also record in QuickTime. So if we just close out all this Facebook stuff there and crack up in QuickTime, I can go to new and then a movie recording. And at this point it will pull open my webcam right there. So first it's gonna grab the one up top and now I just go down to the bottom here and choose GoPro webcam. And now I can make a recording straight into this. So if I needed to record my screen or sorry, I need to record myself for something, this is like the fastest way to do it on a Mac. So overall, I'm pretty darn happy with this. I'm probably gonna start using it for conferencing quite a bit more. It's definitely a much nicer, crispier, wide looking view than certainly my webcam built into my laptop is, or even my other Mac. It's just way, way nicer. That's also a lot wider, gets a lot more things in the shot. It's something that I was expecting the colors, perhaps the lighting quality to be a bit non-ideal on, but it's actually way better than I expected. And again, way better than my webcam is. So there's almost no particular downside to this. I don't have to have any other stuff, but I would like in preferences to be able to go to 4K, for example, even just to capture it 4K for this sort of thing in QuickTime would be awesome. But also to be able to change the digital lenses to maybe the linear view here and there to be able to get a bit more of kind of the non-fisheye look, or in some cases just go to super wide to be able to capture this entire studio on a long ass USB-C cable back into my laptop for as part of a live stream or something like that. So anyways, hopefully you found this interesting and useful. If so, go ahead and whack that like button at the bottom there or hit the subscribe button for plenty more sports technology goodness. With that, have a good one.